Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the tap gesture to make a floating action button fling out related actions. As soon as you import the assets, you'll see we have a floating action button, three related action buttons, and a background image showing our photo app. Add a shadow to all four buttons to add some depth. Then, rearrange them so that the print, share, and upload buttons are centered behind the floating action button. The first thing we want to do is create a tap gesture on the floating action button. Upon selecting the floating action button, you'll see a lightning bolt which reveals gesture options. Select tap and drag the spaghetti code arrow on top of the artboard, which will automatically duplicate it for us in its current state. To transform the plus icon into an X icon, rotate the floating action button by 45 degrees on this new artboard. Then, create another tap gesture linking this X icon back to its original state. Preview the interaction in the viewer to make sure it's working as expected. To make the interaction even smoother, click on the floating action button tap transition arrow above, which will reveal the animation properties. In this case, we only want to change the curve from the default one to be both ease in and out. For consistency, let's apply the same curve to the reverse floating action button tap transition. Looking good. Now we want to show the print, share, and upload buttons fling up from behind the floating action button. The interaction works perfectly well, but it's not very delightful, so let's add some bounce to it. Choose spring as the curve type for each of the three buttons. Set the friction to 15 instead of 20 for even more bounce. Looking good. Lastly, set the curve of these three buttons to ease out on the reverse tap transition. That's it!